Got some portal updates, and these are things that we either got feedback on in the survey we sent producers over the summer, or things that we as a staff just knew needed to happen eventually. We started the portal in May of 2018 and knew that there was going to be a next round of updates, and there will, still be a next round of updates. So it's always a work in progress, but here are where we are with these updates. So you can see that this section doesn't look too different, but there are new pages up at the top. And so I'm currently on the projects page. So if I click that, that's where I am. Still have my producer status and information, my projects here, they're all active, and I have the ability to add a show. I have my shows, reservations, certifications, and classes. And so what's different here is that I have the ability to sort from current or upcoming, and then past shows and reservations as well. So if I drop down shows, you can see that I have one show upcoming. And then if I do past shows, I will see all of my past shows. And nothing here has changed. It'll still show the status if it's been processed. If it failed, we can give you a reason on why that failed, but you'll hear from Charles in an email about why it failed. All right, and then reservations. I'm going to hide the shows. Reservations, I can show that. I have my current upcoming reservations. It will be, you'll see maybe three or four here listed. And what's nice now is that they are sorted by the contract that you'll sign. And so the date range will be here of your reservation. And then the project name is right there. And so these are now grouped. It's more obvious what the grouping is here versus here. And so that's a nice addition. And then we have these question marks, which are still a work in progress. We do not have question marks for all of the gear yet, but we're getting there. So I can have them. We have web pages built for cameras, audio, and lighting. And so if I click on this, let's say the Sony NX Cam, I'm checking that out, and I want to learn more about it or download the manual. I can click on this link, and it goes to a web page that we've built on the AFS website. And these are all of the cameras that we have in stock. And you can download the manuals. Again, it's a work in progress. We'll probably build out a few more bullet points here for you, but just kind of a useful tool for seeing what the gear is. So it creates a new tab on those. And so these are already things that I've reserved, right? So there's a way to see that information on the reservations side as well. Before you make a reservation, you can check in on, see an image of something. So that's what the question marks are. So if I go to, so on camera Frezzy is a light, so I can click on that and it takes me to a light page. So this is all of the lighting gear that we have. All right, and then if I find, let's see, some audio gear, let me go to a past reservation. If I find a past reservation, to find some audio gear. All right, so here's a shotgun mic. Click on that, and then this is our audio page. So those are the three that we've built. We're working on a grip and rigs page, and we'll continue to build these out. But just very helpful to see the images and be able to click their manuals and some other information there. All right, so that's what's different on these on the projects page. There's also a cancel a reservation button. So there's not currently a way for producers to cancel a reservation within the portal, but so we've added this, which will actually bring up your email with Charles's email in it. We'll add Graham and Cameron to that as well, but it's just kind of a quick link to bring up an email to know that that's how you cancel a reservation, is you need to email our equipment staff and let them know. All right, reservations page. Still looks the same as well. We've updated some of these policies here. So, we now work with a 24-hour window. And you may have already seen that if you try to book gear outside of operating hours, it'll give you an error message and it actually prevents you from submitting a reservation. Before, you could still submit a reservation and we had to email you and tell you, hey, here are our operating hours. But now it actually prevents you from hitting the submit button. It also prevents you from booking within 24 hours or more than 30 days. So pretty much if you can get through the reservation process, the gear's available, the timing is within our operating hours, then you should be set. You'll hear from one of us if it doesn't work out, but you just still are required to just double check that things have been approved, right? So you can come here and check the status of your reservation to see that it has been approved, right? You won't get an email from us if it's been approved. It's on you to come back to the portal and check that status. All right, so reservations, again, hasn't really changed a whole lot, but what's cool now is that we have this more information button. So those three pages that I showed you on cameras, audio, and lighting are here. So if you are going to make a reservation and you just forget what that microphone was that you want to use, you don't remember the name of it, just click on the more information and it takes you right to those pages. All right. So everything else, very similar. You will just click, you know, the gear that you want. You'll first have to make a reservation time frame. So I'll do 4 o'clock on Wednesday, and we'll go through Friday at, say, so if I say 7:30, I'm gonna get an error message because we close at 7. So even though we close at 7, the portal's gonna tell you 6:45, and that helps us give some buffer time so you don't show right up at 7 o'clock when we're closed. So just know that. So I'm gonna put 5:30 for this, and then let's go pick a popular camera. Let's see, FS5s. So it says it's unavailable. All right, so I can check availability. So the conflict grid looks a lot nicer now. It's more condensed, more user-friendly. It's just more obvious what's going on. So we have a conflict here with this COA number. So that's City of Austin tag number on the camera. And this is my selected time, start time and date. This is my end time and date. And then I see here that there's a reservation already here and a reservation already here. So somebody's got it booked from 10:24 from 7 o'clock to 10:25, 11:45 a.m. And then somebody's got it booked from 10:25 at noon past our reservation. So really helpful. It'll show you every line will be a new reservation that's a conflict, and it will be in order from left to right. So extremely helpful. So I can either remove it here, I can remove the conflict here, or I can go to back to my submissions page. Just do not hit the back button on your browser. So hit back to submissions, and that camera is still there. I can also X out of it here. So same deal as before, it's just the portal is the conflict grid just looks a lot nicer. So this one I can check the availability on, so I can see again here is my start time and end time, and I can see it's already booked on 10:24 at 9 p.m. through my end time. So, you know, look through that. It's really nice. It's a lot cleaner. But for the studios and the conference room and the edit lab, what we've also added is a calendar. So you can click on the calendar, and it defaults to, at least what I have, what I see, to week view. And these colors are coordinated with these blocks of time. So you can see this is a full week right here. So you can see how crazy it gets around here. So Studio One is in blue, so I can see when that is. So if I was interested for this Saturday, so for Saturday the 26th, I could see that the studio is booked from 12 to 3:30. And so I could actually then go back to my reservations page, and I know that from 3:31 on, or yeah, I don't see the end date. So just know from around 3:30 to 7, it's available and you can go book it. So it's a great visual. Also the edit lab, if you want to come in and edit that day instead of having to come in and then find there's a class, I know that can be frustrating. So just come and see that yellow is the edit lab. So we block those off when there's a class. So like on this Saturday, there's a class from 12 to 6. So that's booked off from 12 to 6. So again, really helpful. And that's there, and you can also switch to day view if you want. So this is today, so there's the back-to-back-to-back shows in Studio One here. The Studio Three is in pink, so a lot of activity on Mondays. All right, so that's really helpful. And then you can close that, and it actually just pops up on any page that you're on. it just drops down. So just hit close and you're good. All right, so I'll go back to my submissions page. And then the last thing is this training. So I can click here and it goes right back to our website with all the training videos for the studios and then the portal, which are currently outdated. I need to make more training videos for the new updates, but also opens in another tab. So again, those are the changes. I don't think I've missed anything. The forgot password link actually works now. I know that's also been frustrating. You hit the I forgot my password and it doesn't do anything, and then you had to email someone on staff. So now if you actually click that, you type in your username, which is your email, it'll actually email you a new password. So very helpful there as well. So let me know if you have any questions, and hopefully you all enjoy these changes. All right.